Some is tradition and legend, but I know their messages continue on to your own present day. Nathaniel is a faithful follower of mine and took a copy of Matthew's gospel from India and parts of what is now Russia. He was martyred for preaching and zealous of sharing his faith. James Less also fell at the hands of his enemies and became a martyr by stoning. Some of his bones are buried under the Church of the Holy Apostles in Constantinople. Andrew was faithful evangelist and missionary taking the gospel into Scythia, which is in southern Russia today, around the Black Sea. His ministry also included Greece and Ephesus. He was crucified and stoned to death on a cross shaped like an X on November 30th in 69 AD. Peter, yes, Peter, he as well as all the apostles denied him, but was repentant and became a bold and fruitful evangelist. On the day of Pentecost, he was filled with the Holy Spirit, became the spokesman, and preached the gospel. Thousands were saved. Later, he journeyed to Lydda, Jaffa, and even into what is now Great Britain. He was martyred in Rome by Nero on Vatican Hill, crucified upside down because he felt he was not worthy to be crucified in the same manner as others. He is entombed in the Vatican City under the basilica named after him. James, son of Zebedee, of whom I said, indeed, you will drink of the cup that I drink of, became the first to be martyred. He was beheaded by King Herod Agrippa in 44 AD. Before his death, he was an effective minister of the gospel, taking a message to many places, including Spain. Some of his bones are entombed in Jerusalem, and others are taken to Spain where they are today. John, the disciple whom I love, was the last of the disciples to die. He took the responsibility for caring for my mother Mary until her death. He was the only apostle to die of natural causes. However, his life was not without persecution. He was exiled to the island of Patmos in order to stop his preaching. But it was there that God gave him the revelation. He is responsible for 5 books of the New Testament, John 1, 2, and 3, and Revelation. His life ended a natural death in Ephesus around 150. Thomas, the apostle accused of having doubt, went on to become one of the most fruitful of all the apostles. He traveled to Babylon and established many churches there, and then on to India, where multitudes were converted. To this day, the work of Thomas is recognized and continued in India. He was martyred by Erastus Freeman and is buried in Lavapunity, now a suburb of Madrasa. Philip also became an effective missionary of the gospel and took a message into Scythia, where he preached for 20 years. From there, he traveled to Hierapolis in Phrygia, where priests of the pagan god sacrificed him and stoned him to death while on the cross. He died praying for his enemies and tormentors as I did. Matthew wrote the gospel that opens the New Testament. He spent most of his life ministering to the Hebrews in Palestine. From there, he traveled to Ethiopia, northern Greece, Syria, and Persia. He is buried in Lavapunity, now in a suburb of Madras. Simon the Zealot carried the message into